Hey everyone, this is Alan from BMW Durham, back again with another video. We have another new arrival. It's the all new 2023 BMW 760i xDrive sedan in Black Sapphire Metallic. All right, so this is the 2023 BMW 760i. And let me go ahead and press that unlock button so you can see the welcome animation. So these are the first time we're seeing these crystal LED headlights. So there's actually 30 LEDs on each headlight that are doing a little dance to welcome you to the vehicle, because I mean, if you have this vehicle, definitely you're a VIP. This one also has the black Shadowline package, so you see the one-piece kidney grille all blacked out. And of course, this car is Black Sapphire Metallic. So, I mean, this thing looks pretty boss, and this is as close as the 7 Series has ever gotten to Rolls-Royce territory in terms of size and mass, but ultimately, man, this thing looks absolutely menacing. If you see this thing pulling up behind you in your rearview mirror, you will not even know what's happening, and if this thing pulls up down the street and you see this thing rolling, you are not going to know what this thing is because you have never seen it before. That's how exclusive this is. This is the first one we've got to our dealership, and I'm just gonna walk all the way around. Look at that new pattern on the lights there as well. 760i, so this is a gas engine vehicle, internal combustion engine. Look at that quad exhaust. We've got this new design for the quad exhaust tips on the rear. That looks really, really awesome. But just the presence that this vehicle has. And another thing I wanted to point out, and it's kind of hard to see because it's bright out, but we do have an animated welcome light carpet, so it is constantly changing what's happening there, which is awesome. And my goodness, look at the shape of this vehicle, the silhouette of this vehicle. Let's take a look at all the closer details. All right, so as we know, we do have the split headlights here, and there is the low beams down here, and it actually says BMW LED in there as well, which is kind of cool. And we do actually have functional air ducts down here. There's a port there for your tow hook. Now, if we come over to the side, so we have 21-inch 909 wheels, 909M wheels in black with the massive blue M Sport brakes there as well. That looks pretty awesome. Now, obviously, in the past 760, there was a V12. So this is the V8. S68, this is the last V8 that BMW says they're going to make, so that's kind of special. And also, as I'm sure you guys have seen, we have crazy doors on this thing as well, and we've got that new style antenna up there as well. We have a huge sunroof that doesn't actually open, but once we get inside, we'll take a look and see if it's got some of the cool sky lounge options. We have the BMW rondel in the back with the camera integrated. If I press this button, I can open the tailgate there. There's a button there to close and lock. We've got grocery bag hanger on either side here. There's a center pass-through through the middle, but the seats do not fold down in a 60-40 split. Carpeted floor mats, front plate bracket. Got a little storage space down here. Glow-in-the-dark handle to get out of here in case you get stuck. And let me open this part up. So there's your tire inflator kit, tow hook, wheel lock keys in there, I'm sure, as well. And I'm pretty confident that I can kick my foot under here, and I can, in order to get that to close, and that looks pretty awesome. Now, once the tailgate is closed, I just want to hit the lock button, and then I just want to press the unlock button to show you guys the taillight animation. So much like the iX, it does come from the middle out to the side, and then we've got that cool pattern going on here, which is awesome. And then let me just back out a little bit so we can get a little bit of a wider angle. All right, so if I come up to the rear passenger door and I press this button here, and then once I move out of the way, it will open all the way, and I can see the animated welcome light carpet down there. And if I open the door all the way here, I can see that we have the Smoke White Merino Leather inside of here, which looks fantastic. And look at these beautiful speaker grills, again with that same pattern that we saw in the taillights. There's an actuator button here, and we also have the 4K screens on each side here as well. You know, that I can turn up the brightness here if I want. There's a lot of cool things you can do here. And we also have the emergency handle just down here as well. We have the illuminated aluminum M door sill. The mats are not in the back here, so if I do sit down, I will take my shoes off as I'm respectful. And back here, look how comfortable this all looks. If I press this, we'll be able to pull down this section here. So there is a pass-through through the center behind here. We do not have a fridge. Headrest can flip up. Button on the side to flip it back down, just like that, right? And if I lift this part up, we do have a little storage compartment. There are two USB Type-Cs in there. There's also an illuminated light. And this part is the cup holders. And put that back, lift that up. So there is actually a seat belt for a center passenger, but I don't know. I don't think that they'd necessarily want to be there. We do also have some lights up here on the ceiling, and it looks like we do have the Sky Lounge. And I don't know if you've seen my other videos, but the new 7 Series, the sunroof scrolls from the front to the back, which is the opposite of all the other cars, which kind of gives emphasis to the rear passengers, which is definitely cool. On the front here, so we've got some pockets in the back of each seat. This particular one, unfortunately, did not option the theater screen, so we do not have the 31.3 inch 8K display. That's okay. Car is still fantastic. We've got some vents on the back of the center console, and I just want to see if what kind of adjustments. So we've got little vent controls here, vent open, close. So typical BMW stuff back here. And I like how there's some ambient lighting coming from under here as well. That's kind of cool. All right, so from back here, I have the ability to also press this button, and I can decide if I want to open or close all the blinds. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click close all first. So we've got this blind, the top one, the one on the side, and the one in the rear. So now that everything's closed, you can see how much darker it is actually in here. And if I click open all, so there is the top, the sides, right, and the rear one as well, all open. And look at that. So we do have the Sky Lounge, so we do have whatever ambient light color coming in through these lines on this, on the roof here, which looks absolutely fantastic. And I'm extremely comfortable back here. Let me open this up and let's get the cup holders out here as well. So very comfortable, ergonomically correct. And what I'm going to do next is let me just press the button over here and let's get the door open. And there's my dirty shoes outside. Let's get out of the car. All right, so I'm outside of the 760i. I'm gonna press and hold the lock button on the key and let's see if we can get all the doors to close. And there you have it. All right, so if I approach from the front passenger door and I press that button, the door will check to make sure it's safe to open, and then it will open up. And inside of here, we do have that interaction light bar. I'm just gonna move the passenger seat back a little bit because there's a lot of space to move back here. And we do have Bowers & Wilkins Diamond Surround Sound. There's that beautiful light interaction bar there as well, which right now looks like we've got Flamingo going on. We have the power seat controls here in crystal, memory seats, seat menu button, lock, unlock. And then down here, we've got the button to the actuator to open the door. There's a fail-safe button down here as well. There's a lever, window switch, little door handle area there. And then inside of here, so let me just get in here. Again, take my shoes off because we don't have the floor mats in. So in here, we do have a button right here that we can press that's going to close my door. It does it rather confidently. And then we've got some vent controls here and such, vent direction. That crystalline interaction bar is actually really cool. And down here, wireless charging tray and communication pad. This is the digital key, comes with the car. If I open these square little boxes, we have circular cup holders in there. And on the center, we have your crystal start-stop button, gear selector. Sorry about the camera angles. We have your iDrive controller and your crystal volume knob. And in this vehicle, we do have air suspension. So if I press that, the height of the car will raise up. Temporarily unavailable. And we also have this button that will luxuriously open up the glove box down there. And I don't think there's anything in there that I need to show you per se. And then we've got rear defrost, four-way flashers, max front defrost, and then these are your vent controls. And then we have these to direct the vents in different directions. And over here, so we have a button that I can press that's going to be for your rear view camera. And that's for park assist mode. And over here, we've got auto hold. And if I press this, it splits open. There's two USB Type-C charging ports and a 12-volt plug, and the armrests do heat with the heated seats as well. Let's go over to the driver's side next. All right, so if we approach from the driver's side, if I press this button here and we step back, give it space to open, sensing us that we're not in the way. Again, we have that light interaction bar going on. Memory buttons for the driver's side, seat menu button, lock, unlock. Love the mesh there for the speaker grill. I've got the crystal controls there. So this is the child safety button. This is the menu for all of the door menus. All window controls are one touch up and down. Left and right side mirror. Adjust the side mirror, fold the side mirrors in, and then you've got your tailgate button there as well. And there's the emergency release handle here as well for getting out in case the door actuator doesn't work. And then we've got these beautiful smoke white leather seats. And inside, this is called the carbon fiber, or M carbon fiber with black trim. Inside, we've got the paddle shifters. We've got cruise control. If you hold this down, you've got 10 seconds of extra boost. You've got head-up display in here. And of course, we've got that beautiful curved display for BMW iDrive 8. And through that light interaction bar, there's a number of different things that you can see. So to give you an example, if I press my modes over here and I put the car into sport mode, you'll see everything turns red, and then you'll see the M blue colors swooshing in on each side, which is absolutely awesome. And let me just jump in here for a second. So I manually close the door like a peasant, but there's a button here that I could press that automatically opens and closes the door. And this is the new style steering wheel with the M badging on here. We've got some of the controls here for radio and content. So if I press that, we're in sport mode, so we can only adjust the content that's there and the content that would be in the head-up display as well, right? So directional view and assisted view. So all of the same kind of stuff as we've seen in all the other ones. However, this one also has augmented view. So if you're navigating somewhere, you'll be able to see on the camera where you should be going, which is kind of cool that it's right in front of the driver instead of on this screen over here, as you've seen in the iX and the new X1. Map view, G-force meter, and media. So that's all really good. Now I'm just going to hit my modes and go back to personal. So the seat just opened up a little bit, and now if I press this button on the steering wheel, I'll be able to also change the layout. So I have the option for focused, wide, and the one side that actually makes room for more content in the center. So if, like, for instance, if you've got this map view, right? So that's all really good. And let's see what else we can show you here. So I'm just going to press this so that we can get over to the interior lighting menu, which I can also just, there's a shortcut up here. So anytime you see those three little lines, so I'm just gonna put that to the max. And so lighting events, welcome, safety and warning. So if I press the four-way flashers, for instance, the whole thing is flashing on the inside and the outside. So let me just press that again. And we've also got a whole plethora of different colors. So yes, that was the flamingo. Let's try out the lavender. I think that will look awesome in here. Man, this interaction bar is actually so crazy. Now, also just want to try out another thing here that I wanted to try, just because I know that this sound system is absolutely ridiculous. So if we go to sound and we go to experience the sound, activate audio output to play. Oh, volume's not on, that's why. right, so that was pretty awesome. And let me just mute that before I get some kind of strike against me in terms of content and licensed music. So that was pretty awesome. Now I'm going to say the system that I saw yesterday in the IX M60 was actually pretty awesome too. The way that you could adjust all the rumbles and stuff that are in the seats. So that was pretty cool. Now, I think that's pretty well everything that I wanted to show you in here. There's a switch here for the sunshade as well. And if you tilt, it actually just opens up a little bit in the rear. So for instance, if the sunshade is all the way closed, if I press this up, which I'd normally do for tilt, it just opens a little bit on the back there, right? And then if I press back, then it'll close. So the sunroof or the sunshade controls are a little bit different in here than all the other BMWs. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to press this automatic door button. The door will open, allowing me to exit the vehicle. And then once I get out, I can press the button that's here again, and I can step out of the way, and the door will close. Now you can't really see it, but there is actually a hood release just underneath here. And once you pull this down, it actually says two times on it. So pull it twice. Let's go take a look at that S68 and let's be fancy. All right, so the hood is popped open. There's nothing for you to find under here. You just lift this up and there it is. This is the all new S68 4.4 liter V8 twin power turbo. So this has 536 horsepower and 558 foot-pounds of torque. We know that's underrated. And look at that. Is that the positive battery terminal? I've never seen it actually looking like that before. Negative battery terminal is down here and the washer fluid is way over there. Now, this part of the vehicle does not have an automatic opening or closing function. So you just have to slam it down from about halfway like so. All right, so the last one that we had was a pre-production model, so I didn't get a chance to remote start it or anything like that. So I'm just gonna set the camera down here and let's try a cold start and maybe a couple of revs if we can do it without getting in trouble. So I think that sounded pretty good. I love the V8 sounds. All right, so before I conclude the video, I just want to do one final walk around all the way around so you guys can see all the angles and lines of this vehicle as best as I can represent in the space provided here. This is definitely a VIP weapon. And it definitely has some serious presence. I mean, people who have walked by while I was recording this video were commenting on how this looks very Rolls Royce. And I admittedly it does, but just very different and has some serious presence. All right, everyone. So that was my tour of this beautiful 2023 BMW 760i xDrive sedan in black sapphire metallic with the smoke white merino leather inside. I think the car looks awesome. It's spec'd really well. I mean, you can't really spec this car poorly, but I love how it is. If you like the video, if you like the car, if you like me, make sure you like, share, subscribe. We'll see you on the next video. Thank you so much for watching.
Wow, that's nice.
All right, so I'm outside of the i7. All right, so I'm just standing outside of the 7 Series. All four doors are open, as you can see. I'm gonna press and hold the lock button. and the two front doors closed.